The next drawing tool we're going to learn how to use is Polyline. Contrary to line, Polyline creates continuous line segments which are interdependent. Furthermore, using this tool, apart from straight lines, we can also create arcs. Simply put, a polyline can consist of both straight lines and arcs that all are considered as one object. The Polyline tool too can be found in both the Draw menu and the Home ribbon if we look at the panel Draw. Same as every drawing tool we have learned, we can just type the word Polyline in the command line and press Enter to activate it. To draw a polyline, I will click on the polyline icon on the home ribbon. Once the tool is active, I have to click somewhere in the drawing area to define where the line starts. Notice that a message appears that prompts me to specify the first point of the line. I'm going to click on a random point of the drawing area to define the start of the polyline. Another message appears that prompts me to specify the next point of the polyline. Since I want to create a line of certain length and angle, I will type the number 100 in the lengths field, which is currently active, and press Tab to activate the angles field. Once the angles field is active, I will type the number 5 and then I will press Enter. At this point, I have to remind you that since I am using the AutoCAD ISO template and the line is rather short, I have to zoom in to see it clearly. The Polyline tool remains active and I can continue creating linear segments. But before I continue, I want you to take a look at the command line. By default, when I select Polyline, straight lines are being created. However, in the command line I am given the choice to change that. I will click on Arc and notice that as I am moving the cursor, the preview has changed from line to arc. The message that now appears prompts me to specify the end point of the arc. I will type the number 70 for its length, then I will press Tab to set an angle of 30 degrees, and finally I will press Enter to create the arc. The arc is created and the tool will continue creating arcs until I change it back to the line from the command line. Before I do that, I want you to take a look at the command line again and notice that there are different options there now. I can choose to specify the included angle by clicking Angle, where the center of the arc is by clicking Center, the direction of the arc by clicking Direction, or the radius of the arc by clicking Radius. However, I won't elaborate on these options because they are the same with those that we have learned in the lesson about arcs. Now, in case I don't know any of the aforementioned values, I can select Second Point, which is similar to the 3-point arc option. Once I select Second Point, I need to define a random point of the arc and then its end point. As you can see, by using this option, you don't usually aim for mathematical precision, but it can prove really useful in case you need to imprint an arc from an imported file. In the command line, there are a few more options like Undo, which deletes the last segment of the polyline, Line, which turns the tool back to drawing linear segments again, and Close, which creates a closed loop automatically. I will select Undo to remove the last arc I created, and then I will select Line. To draw a vertical line, I will turn Ortho mode on, and then type the length, which will be 80 meters. Finally, I will click Close to create a closed profile. I will select the profile and notice that indeed, contrary to the line tool, all the segments belong to a single object. Now I will press Delete to remove the polyline I created and show you something interesting you can do with the polyline tool. I will create an arrow using polyline. Firstly, I will select the polyline tool again and I will click on a random place to define the first point of the line. Then, from the command line, I will select the option Width. With the width option, I can change the thickness of the line evenly, practically increasing the line weight, or unevenly in order to create other shapes. In the command line, a message appears to inform me that I need to specify the starting width. I will type the number 3 and then press Enter. Then, I need to specify the ending width of the line, which in this case will also be 3 because I want to create an even, thick line. Now, all I need to do is specify the next point or type the length. In this example, I will type the length, so I will type the number 60, and I will press Enter. At this point, a line is created, but I also need a triangle to finish the arrow, so I will select Width again. I will set the starting width 12 and the ending width 0. As you can see in the preview, a triangle has been created, and next I need to define its height and direction. I will lead the cursor upwards, type the number 18 to define the height, and press Enter. Finally, I will press Escape to deactivate the tool, and notice how quickly and easily I created an arrow. There's one thing you must remember though every time you use the width option. The next time you will select the Polyline tool while working on the drawing, you may have to reset the starting as well as the ending width to 0.